Past midnight on Friday when the decision was taken to suspend debate on the amendments to the property tax legislation. It was supposed to be pushed through the parliament in one night, but leader of government business Colm Imbert said there was a necessary change of plan.
If we had continued last night, we'd have gone till about 5 a.m. this morning, and we didn't think that was appropriate. You know, this is an important debate, and we felt people should have the opportunity to look at it on television and inform themselves. So we went until about a little after 1 o'clock, and we have adjourned until Monday, resuming at 1:45 on Monday, at which time we will complete the debate.
Imbert claims there's a lot of misunderstanding about the new tax structure.
There's a lot of misinformation in the system, and huge sums of money are being bandied about, you know, $5,000, $10,000. None of this is true. You know, the average tax is going to be less than $1,000 per year, so that we need to explain this, and that is another reason why we felt we should resume the debate on Monday.
The debate generated heated protests outside the parliament. There were claims that the police used unnecessary force. One union leader was arrested. Minister Imbert declined comment on the confrontation, saying he wasn't there to see who was right or wrong.
Well, people are entitled to protest. I mean, you have a right to protest. What they did that, in my view, was not correct was that they were making too much noise, because we could hardly hear ourselves speak inside the chamber. And it's well known, well established, that we shouldn't disturb the debate. I mean, if it had just been a quiet protest, I don't think there have been any issues at all. But I myself came out on the public gallery, and I did hear what appeared to me to be a megaphone or some form of amplification, and that is not allowed.
The minister is also insisting that the protest was all politically motivated and did not represent the views of the wider population.
That is not an expression of a popular sentiment, in my opinion. That is not a mass of people, you know, from the grassroots or a wide cross-section of people in Trinidad and Tobago. That is a pressure group.
For CNC3, I'm Roshan Sukram.